So here's a little overview over 5.6a. That is the one shot that I've showed you the clean plate creation with. So this is the one where Tom is being held by the robot, and on the bridge while shooting we have been simulating that with broomsticks. So we've been holding them and then releasing them to make the actor react to that. And of course we had to remove the broomsticks. And if you have watched the clean plate tutorial, you know how to create a clean plate without the stuff here in the background. But still, we don't want to replace everything, but just some part of the background. So in the main file, we had to use some masking. So that's why you have in the masking mode in the movie clip editor, the mask for Tom. And it's made of four different parts, mask layers. So one for the back part of the jacket, then for the head, for the neck, and for the front part, because that way it's easier to control and animate these masks separately. Then there are masks for the left stick, because we didn't want to replace everything, but just the part where you can actually see the this broomstick, and the same for the right stick. And then some additional masks for some compositing issues that we had while replacing the shirt. And also, well, there's some more stuff. Okay, so let me do a quick render with lower samples so that you can see what's going on. So maybe just use 5 samples or something so that it renders quickly. Okay, so now it's rendered and it has been rendering several render layers. So if you go down here, you can see we have a render layer for the robot, then for the railing. And then at first we wanted to put some space harbor here in the background, but then we dropped that because it was just taking too long and it didn't really add that much to the scene, so we ended up not doing it. Then there's a render layer for the background with a clean plate, and then one for the shirt. So the shirt is using this beautifully modeled proxy object. It has projected one frame of the footage onto that. Then we have the railing here. If I zoom in, this is also on a layer that shouldn't actually be rendered. So that is here. So this is the railing that is actually being rendered. And it has a material also with an image of the actual railing projected onto it. So let's have a look at the results. These errors here are because I've been using OpenCL, but on my computer, because I have a crappy graphics card, that doesn't work. So here, these are the masks for the sticks. Right stick, left stick, then they are added to each other. And then here, there is the mask of Tom, because that of course has to be masked out. Then there's some mixing on. Okay, so here's the footage. Actually, here's the background. So the background layer also has some noise to it. Then it is being mixed over the actual footage here by making use of the masks. Like so. And it's not quite perfect here, that's true, but well, I think for the movie it works good enough. Then here is the shirt. The shirt layer is using ambient occlusion to get the shadow of the robot hand, and also is using the diffuse color pass just to make it like a shadeless texture of that shirt. And that we have to use to hide this part of the broomstick. So it's using that layer only on a certain part. So where is it? So the diffuse color has the noise, and then it is being overlaid with the mask. And the mask here is currently turned off because it's being animated, so that the shirt is not always overlaid, but just during the frames where the robot is actually releasing him. So that's what we have here. And then here is the layer with the robot. So just very few samples to make rendering quicker. Then there is some defocus going on, some color corrections, some denoising, some despeckling. And then the other thing that has been quite complicated to achieve was to set up the masks or the object IDs, so that the robot can be actually in front but also in the back of Tom. So because this model is not really that great and some other reasons, we couldn't use Z masking. So that's why I was using the object IDs. So each of these fingers of the robot has an object ID. So this part, these things, and here. So I've been using them to separate the fingers, and then with an additional mask for the fold of the shirt, I've been cutting off that. This has also been animated. So by multiplying with black, if this would be factor one, then this object ID would be also black, so the mask would be gone. And that is when the finger should be behind Tom, but now it's in front. So it's cutting in this hole in the alpha channel, like so. So now it's in front, and on different frames it's then in the background, just because the mask is then set up differently by the animation of this one multiply node. Okay, so that's that. Then here, down there, you have the railing. So the railing is using the alpha channel to control the edge a little bit more. Then this edge is then used to also put into the alpha channel. And here there is a mask. If I turn off Tupas, I think it's better to see. So there is a mask which is being blurred. And I think this blur has been happened because this file has been created before the feathering worked properly, I guess. Otherwise, I would have used feathering. So it's blurring. This has been added to the alpha channel as well, so that here at this point, the railing has this nice fade in. So here you can see how it fades in, and then there's a little bit of blur and a little bit of noise. And when it's then overlaid over the original footage and the finished composite, it blends in nicely with the real railing, so that way we have this railing now in front of the robot. I mean, if you look at it like this, it looks a little bit fake, but I think in the movie it works quite nicely. One thing you notice is here there is this weird gap, so it looks like there is some kind of error, but that's just because I've been rendering this at frame 2372. The start frame is here, so if you render that somewhere in the middle, so like this, for example, then you wouldn't have this gap. So this is also now totally not working, but if I render that, you can see it actually works. Maybe I can also pick a frame where the robot is just about to release him. So I think here, or maybe, let's see. Okay, so here you should also see how the shirt is being replaced. So if I render that, so here you can see it works a bit better now. Here's also the area where the shirt is replaced. It's not perfect, but I think it's doing the job. It could be a bit smoother here maybe, but I think in the movie it works okay. And then finally, I forgot to show you, the clean plate here is in this background. So because I didn't animate or do anything with Cycles depth of field, I could use the plate here in the main file, so there are no separate scenes like in some other files. So that is the clean plate, and because the camera is just doing this tripod rotation motion, it's very easy to put it here in the background and it would stick to the footage nicely. So that is that. Then here there is also a fake road just to provide some red bounce light. So that is here, it's just for lighting. Lighting is also just a simple sun lamp. So that was quite easy, and the robot behaves nicely here in the light on the bridge. So that's basically it. And that's 5.6a.